welcome everybody to our 2024 Girls Ministries Celebration Award Ceremony. My name's Samantha Kramer. I am the Girls Ministries Coordinator at Praise Assembly here. And we are so thankful for you guys coming out and supporting your kids and just in all of their accomplishments that they've done this past year, all of the events that we've had. It's just been an awesome past year. So we're gonna get into it in a second. I'm gonna wait on the awards because we're just gonna tell you a little bit about the program first. You can go ahead and flip to the next slide, Pastor Brandon. We do have a mission for Girls Ministries. It's just to, for every girl to have a relationship with Jesus and to really understand where they are and what he has planned for them in their lives. And that's already evident in so many of these young ladies' lives and those that are going into college next year, which is just crazy for some of them. They're already there, some of them. But we are really proud of all of they've done. So again, thank you for coming out. I'm just going to open up in a word of prayer real quick. Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for this night, God. Thank you for the opportunity to minister to these girls. God, I thank you for every leader that spends so much time investing in these kids, God. I thank you for the parents that bring their kids to this ministry. They understand the importance of girls growing with Jesus and learning his word. God, I just pray over the ceremony tonight and just pray a blessing over everything in your name. Amen. All right. So again, we have a great mission. A lot of the girls have already gotten to know Jesus even further in their lives, and even our young kids, we have boys and girls in our youngest group, they are already understanding what it means to follow Jesus and what it means to be a helper for the Lord. Again, before we get into our awards too much, I just want to specify that Girls Ministries is a gender-specific program, minus our youngest group, which is our preschool friends. But there's a couple of reasons for that, right? Girls definitely have different needs than boys do. We like to talk a lot more probably than boys do. So having an opportunity to be in a room with just girls, we're going to be open. We're going to be sharing more things with each other. We're going to be praying over each other for things that we might be struggling with, all of those areas. So it's a great opportunity to get your girls out. If you know friends that you could invite, it's an amazing opportunity just to get them plugged in and to see. We also have Royal Rangers that meets on Wednesday nights for the boys. They meet up at the cabin. So again, different needs, right? Guys talk about different things. There's different topics involved. So definitely get them out into all of those. We also have co-ed programs or ministries here. If you're not aware, we have youth group for middle school and high school kids. That's every first and third Friday of the month. So if you want information on that, Pastor Hans isn't here tonight, but I can probably give you a calendar coming up. So talk to me afterwards. And we also have life groups on Sunday mornings from 9 to 9:50, and that's every age range. That's on, again, Sunday morning, I think I said that. But it's free. That's free. Get your kids here. Get them here. Get them invested in the word. Get them understanding what it means to have that relationship with Jesus. It's so, so, so important. All right. So before we do these awards, there is a video that I'd like to share from our national website. Again, just telling you a little bit more about what we do, what our mission is, and what we aim to achieve in our program.
I am a girl. I am strong and beautiful. My goal is to love Jesus and honor others. I value myself and my friendships, and I want to grow into the girl I'm called to be. Because I'm confident in truth, I'm empowered and accepted. By being a light, I want to see my friends have a relationship with Jesus too. I have amazing potential. I am God's masterpiece. Together, we're forming lasting and life-changing friendships. We're cultivating a community of all-stars who encourage each other with support and accountability. Because we're girls. And together, we will influence our world.
All right. Girls Ministries really is the only gender-specific program ministry that we know of. And so I'm so glad that you're here tonight and that you parents especially, you're investing in the spiritual formation of your daughters. And that's just so important today. You know, think about the wisdom that's in the world today versus the wisdom that's in God's word. And that's what these girls are getting every week. Now, listen, I'm up here because I'm going to ask you to give tonight, not for the program, but for missions through this program. And we'll have ushers. Some of the girls are going to be ushers, and they're going to come. And if you're, whatever you give tonight is strictly going to missions. It's not going to stay here at this church. It's not for this program. I want to make that clear. But before we do that, this is my opportunity. I want to say thank you to all of our sponsors, our club sponsors, all the women that work here every Wednesday night, all throughout the year. We don't take summers off. Hopefully some of them did take some time off. But can I just ask the ladies and all the workers, all the volunteers, all the helpers, just to stand real quick so we can acknowledge you. We want to know who you are, especially if your daughter's not in one of these classes. Please stand. Thank you. Thank you so much for your faithful service. Thank you. You can go ahead and be seated. I cannot thank you often enough. So really appreciate you. So listen, I'm going to pray, and then the girls will come and receive from you. Whatever you can give tonight, again, this will go. I know that some of their funds this year are going to a ministry in Peru. I'm not sure where this will go for, but it is for world missions. So let's pray together. God, we thank you, Lord, for your blessings in our lives. We thank you for the abundance that we enjoy here in this nation. And Lord, I pray, God, that you would bless all that's received tonight. Lord, that you would somehow multiply it out in the field for your purpose. And I pray your blessing on each one of us as we give to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
I want to thank Miss Marissa for putting that video together. Thank you very much. It was so great just to see pictures just from this past year. And there's so many other events that happened this past year that we didn't have photos of, but our goal this year is to take more photos and just show you everything that we're doing, because the kids have such a great time. I'm sure they tell you when they get picked up. If we have something special, like we had pottery night this year, we had a bonfire outside, we did a lot of awesome little events, and there's a lot more coming in the fall too. So I'm sure they tell you all of the stuff that they do, but it's so fun. It's so fun. On top of learning about God's word, it's just extra fun. So the first group that I'm going to invite now up to the stage is our preschool group, our Rainbows or Noah Zoo Club. So if you guys want to come on up, come on up. This is their 5 minutes of fame. Come on, come on. All right. Okay, Asher, take him to the stage. Here, Shane, I'm going to have you step right here. Good job. All right, and those leaders that are for Rainbows, we have Miss Gloria, we have Miss Jenny, and we have Miss Artaya Broom, who just joined us this past year. So we're super thankful for all of them and all that they do. And I'm gonna pass the mic to Miss Gloria.
Hi. These guys are ages 3 to 5, and we tell stories and we read stories to the kids, and they get excited to tell us all about Jesus. And then we have them sit down. They'll either do a craft of some kind or a lesson. And they're a spunky little bunch. They keep us on our toes. And we do little things with the kids, too, because it's hard to take them to do too many things. Like we did a swimming outside, as you saw in the video. The kids were in the big pool, and we did little things like that. And then what else did we do? Oh, we do Simon Says. And then we play instruments. If you ever hear a lot of noise in the hallway, it's us. But now I'll turn it over to Jen, and she can hand out the awards.
Okay, so Nate Walters completed 20 units. Shane Smith completed 11. Sebastian Petrucci completed 3. Nolan Walters completed 2.
We'll go stand next to Sam.
Asher Samuel completed 7. Tabat Domte completed 18. Azra Allen completed 7. And Samantha Petrucci completed some.
I don't have the number.
All right, I guess that's everybody. Oh, thank you. So we have some honorees. We have Tabat Domte. Tabat. Look at all those back. Look at all those. You did so much. Stay over here, baby. Tabat, come here, baby. Come this way. Come up back up here. Good job. All right. Nate Walters. Look at all those, Nate. And Samantha Petrucci. And then Natalie Nash, but she's not here.
All right, thank you so much. Great job, guys. You can go sit down. If they want to go with their parents, they can too, so that's okay.
You have to get your bag and then you can go to your parents.
Okay, bye. Okay. They're so cute. Rainbows was one of our largest groups this year. We had anywhere from like 15 to 20 kids on some Wednesday nights, so that's why we needed a couple extra hands. It was a very blessed year, and we have a lot moving up into Rangers and a lot moving up into Daisies. So next year, this will be the largest Daisies group that we've had in many years coming up, about 8 daisies coming in. So super excited. I know Jenny and them will appreciate having a lighter, you know, group of kids this coming year. All right, next up, we have our daisies, which is our kindergarten group. And our leaders for daisies are Christelle Brewer and Brittany Smith. And daisies is only 1 year because it's kindergarten. So they don't have to do as many badges to honor, but we do have 2 honorees. We have Ivy Allen and we have Abby Dorno as well that are honoring.
Hello, hello. I'm Brittany Smith and this is Christelle Brewer. We're the daisies leaders. Daisies is kindergarten, so it is 1 year. And our motto is daisies tell about Jesus, which the girls definitely have been learning about. A few of their favorite badges are growing, where they learn how to take care of their bodies, both spiritually and nutritionally, and then also believing, of course, where they learn to believe in the one true God and Jesus Christ, and to bring him into their hearts and learn how to live for him. And then, let's see, what else? Respecting is a big one that we like to teach as well, just because when they're moving up to prims, we like to make sure, you know, they're ready for that maturity step into first grade, and learning to respect their parents and their leaders. And yeah, I think that's it. We love these girls. They have a lot of fun. We do lots of crafts. And we also like to incorporate them in the prims group so that when they do move up into prims, they're ready. They know the girls already. They know the teachers and the leaders. So, and then we're going to go ahead and do the badges.
So we have one of the things about Girls Ministries, because we're year-round, you can join at any time. And we really like to celebrate their accomplishments no matter what. So Eliana has come with us, and she was able to already earn 2 badges, and I really am excited about that for her. She was only here for a few months, and then she's also going to be moving up to prim, so we only had her for a little bit of time, but she's coming up to prim, so congratulations, Eliana. And we've been blessed to be able to have the Allen girls. So we've had Lola, who's already in prims, and we've had Ivy this year. She's a bundle of joy, and Ivy has made sure she was here and ready. So she has completed 11 units. Really quickly, we have 15 total badges, and our girls need anywhere between 9, at 9 to honor. So getting those 11 is a lot. We also have Abby Dorno, and Abby also came in late, but she powered through and was able to complete all 9 units. And last but not least, we have Talia. So Talia is a little one that, not little, she's not little, I shouldn't say that. She was a rainbow that missed the cutoff for kindergarten, and she came up with us to just see if she'd be able to handle daisies. She completed 9 units, knocked it out the box, but we will have the privilege of having Talia one more year just to get her ready for prims, because Miss Patty and Miss Megan do not play. So we're going to keep her with us, but she did complete 9 units with us, and then she'll work on some new ones next year. So congratulations, Talia.
Thank you. All right, you ladies can have a seat. Good job. Super proud of all of you. Again, they're going to have 8 next year, so get ready. At least 8. We're praying for even more. Blessings over you. All right, next group is Prim. So that is Miss Megan Walters and Miss Patty Vozanelic. Now, Miss Megan just got, she's a hardcore soccer player, and she just found out, well, she was playing over the weekend, but just found out that she tore her ACL. So she's making it up with the assistance of her husband, and we are going to celebrate all of these ladies coming in. Another one of our largest groups, Prims, they just kept multiplying from the beginning of the year, which is awesome, but yes. So I'm gonna pass it off to Ms. Megan.
Hi everyone, I'm Megan, I'm one of the leaders for Prims. I just wanted to say that we've had an amazing year with our girls, probably one of the best ones, I think, in like the 5 years that I've been a part of this group. I think it's such an honor to get to know these girls. They really pushed through this year. It's come to a point where I get excited every week to see these girls. They've grown, we've grown so close to them as leaders And speaking of growth, our group has grown so much and our girls have grown so much. Communication, we think, is a big one. They know when to speak their mind and they're not afraid to sometimes. Growing in their friendships, these girls love to play together, do crafts, really create a special bond, which is so sweet to see. Our motto is to be kind and thoughtful, so they really have gone above and beyond in this, and it just makes us so proud. I want to say thank you to our parents, especially. I know Pastor P and Sam talked about this, but it wouldn't be possible without you parents bringing them every week and making it a point for them to know that it's important to come every week and learn more about God. So I just want to say thank you. Yeah.
Also, I just want to add, we're also called the Discovery Group, and this age truly is doing a lot of discovering. They're learning to read. They're learning to be social. These girls have really become close friends. We do a lot with the daisies, and it really does help the daisies feel comfortable coming into our group, especially when there's so few at this time. But there's second graders that are good friends with the kindergartners. It's absolutely wonderful, the social aspect that they get from this as well. We're not as hard on them as Ms. Christel said. But we have a total of 27 units, but in order to honor, they only need 18. So it's kind of like get 9 each year. Some years they might get a little bit more because I do try to power through the badges so that the majority of the girls can honor. So we'll do 2 lessons a night, and within 2 weeks they've got a badge. They have to do their memory verses as well. But we're really proud of all that they're doing. I'm going to give it back to Megan.
So we have maybe like 1 or 2 girls that aren't here, but we'll go in order from what we have. So we have Miss Lola Allen. She completed 7 units. Okay. We have Rory Chestnut, who's also completed 7 units. We have Cece Cote, who came in towards the end of the year, but she completed 1 unit, so we're excited to have her next year as well. We have Abrielle Morris, who's completed 9 units. And then I'm going to try and not mess up this name, but Grace, I'm going to mess it up. Njoroge is her last name, Grace. She completed 9 units as well. We also have Joanna Paul, who's completed 8 units. And then we also had Lucy Petrucci come in earlier this year, and she completed 3 units. We have Marie Smith, who's completed 8 units. And those were all of our first graders, so they'll come back with us next year. So our second graders who are going to be moving up to STARS, we have Ruth Abera, who's completed 9 units. And then we have Rosemary Krebs, who has completed all the requirements, so she's gotten 18 units, so she's going to be an honor prim this year.
And I just want to say that Rosie has done an amazing job. She is unbelievable. She is such a leader in our group. She shows leadership potential. She is amazing at drawing. And she's just a wonderful child to have in the group. And I'm sad that we're losing her, but STARS is going to have someone wonderful in their group. So I just want to say thank you again to the parents and to the kids. We love having them. Thank you.
All right, ladies, you can go have a seat. Thank you so much. Great job. And now, maybe the best club of all. I'm just kidding. I'm biased. STARS, you guys can go ahead and come up. And I'm biased because I have the privilege of still being one of their leaders, but I'm not going to talk for our kids, but just know that I love every single one of you, and I'm mad at those that are growing up and moving to middle school next year. But I'm going to pass it off to Miss Marissa.
Hello. So STARS is 3rd through 5th grade, and Miss Ani and I did have the privilege of this being our first year doing it with these amazing girls, and trust me, they are funny. They are funny girls. We have a great time with them, and we just love building relationships with your kids, honestly. Like, it is such a blessing to continue to grow with them and learn with them. And everything like that. So some of the things that we did do, one of them being glamping. If you don't know what that is glam camping. glam camping. We did pottery. We also did African studies with Ms. Sade. She actually did a banquet for us. Thank you, Ms. Sade. And some of the units that we did were integrity, prayer, growing, and forgiveness. Now, we do have a few of our girls moving up to friends. One of them is Rayla Harwood. Another one is Somatochi Ibiam. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. I'm sorry. Then we have, yes, so-so. And then we have Tobechi or Toby Ibiam. And we have Naomi Michael. So those are all moving up to friends, which we are very sad to lose them after growing so close with them. And we do have a few staying. One is Nympha Katimu, Rylan Lowe, which is not here tonight either, Eliana Morris, and Aurelia Priego. So, and Miss Ani is going to hand out the words.
So first, we have Eliana Morris with 18 units. Then we have Aurelia Priego with 6 units. And then Naomi Michael had 18 units. Toby had 15 units. And So-So had 14 units. And last but not least, Rayla had 11 units.
Anyways, we just want to thank you guys so much for bringing your kids and just allowing us to grow in relationship with them and help grow their faith with the Lord. And we're going to miss you guys for those that are moving up. And for those that are not, I'll see you soon.
All right. Thank you, ladies. You can go ahead and take a seat. I think one of my favorite things, Ms. Marissa and Ms. Ani, that we do in our club is we do motion memory verses. And you saw it in the video, Ms. Marissa and Ms. Ani had like reindeer antlers up. I can't tell you what that motion was for. I honestly don't remember, but it helps. So if your kid's having trouble memorizing verses, start throwing in some motions and doing that kind of stuff. It helps. I know some of you grew up listening to songs too to help you remember verses or different parts of scripture, so it works. All right, next, we have our middle school group, our Friends Club, so go ahead and come on up. Our leaders for Friends are Ms. Debbie Edwards and Ms. Kayla Velasquez. And we have a small group tonight. There's usually many more of them, but, we also have two honorees coming in. As you can see by their purple tassels, we have Gianna Allen and Jalenice Tirado are our honorees for Friends as well.
Yes, I feel a bit underdressed up here tonight. But just as Ms. Samp said, we are the middle school girls group. We're aptly named Friends because a lot of friendships start and grow in this group. And I hope they last a lifetime for these girls. These girls, some of them are going into middle school and they're just joining youth group. Other girls are going out of middle school. They're leaving us and going into high school. So it is a thrilling time at this age. And I'm excited to be a part of that and witness these girls and the changes they go through in their lives. Now, just like all the other groups, we have unit lessons that we work on. Our units have 6 lessons to them. And we also have a craft or an activity that we need to do. So it takes like 7 weeks to complete one of our units. That's a commitment, and that's a lot of work. So this is where I'm going to go say thank you to all you chauffeurs. What you do helps them do what they need to do. So thank you very much for that. Some of the units we worked on this year were family life, choices, multiculturalism, taming the tongue. That was fun. Self-control, and we started battle stations, but then summer snuck up on us because we had a lot of things going on. So we moved on. The year started with Robin Ravel and myself as the leaders here. And this is where I do a big plug and say thank you to Robin Ravel for all her years of service to this ministry. That is quite a commitment. We both have done it for 20-something years. And it is something that you really get hooked on. And then we had some changes took place, and now I have Kayla Velasquez helping me. And I'll tell you what, I could not be happier. The transition was so smooth because she already had a relationship with a lot of these girls through the youth group. And I am thrilled also to work side by side with her because I watched her grow up. And I was, I don't know if I personally had you in a group when I was teaching at the other church, but I know I was teaching at the same time, but to work side by side with her is a thrill for me. Yeah, full circle. I love seeing that. So right now I'm actually going to hand it over to her. I'm going to be quiet at this point, and she's going to hand out the awards.
Hello, my name's Kayla. I just wanted to just give a shout out to these girls. Our motto is we are committed to God, and these girls are committed to God. They're just so excited to learn more about Him and to share with their friends, and I just think it's so encouraging. At their age, I wish I was as confident as you girls are at your age to be bringing friends and inviting friends. We have so many girls that aren't here tonight, but it's because these girls have invited them, and it's just been so awesome. So I'm very proud of each of you, and I'm glad, even though some of you are moving up, I get to see you at youth group still. So first tonight, we have Abigail Samuel, who has completed 4 units, and we get to keep her next year. Next, we have Libby Kamaji. She has completed 8 units. And she is entering high school, so we unfortunately are losing her, so we will miss her. And first, so we have 2 honorees tonight. We have Jana Allen and Jalenice Tirado. So first I'll start with Jalenice. You have 19 units, and I am so proud of you. I'm so proud of the woman you are and excited for you. So here you are. And Gianna Allen has also completed 19 units and will be honoring and moving up. So I'm so proud of you too, Gianna. But thank you again to each of you parents for bringing each of these girls. We're just so excited and just proud of all the work they've done.
All right, thank you. I'm just gonna ask Miss Debbie and Miss Kayla to go over to the table, and then I'm gonna send my other 2 friends down back to their seats, Libby and Abby, if you can go back down to your seats. Great job, thank you. I'm gonna ask the parents of Gianna and Jalenice if you guys can come up and stand on either side of your girls. Ladies, if you wanna just scoot down that way. All right, so now we get to embarrass them a little bit more. So as a friend honoree, I will say there is so much work involved in the process of honoring. Yes, you have to complete at least 18 units. They both completed 19, but there's way more involved in the process. They have to take a test, and they have to memorize at least 18 verses within this. It's a written test, but I have the privilege to say that these ladies not only memorized 18 verses, they went above and beyond and started filling out extra verses that they knew that were also on the test, because I didn't cross out the other ones from their other, you know, it's just ones that they had already memorized. Not in friends, in other units, in youth group, in just them reading their scripture. So huge shout out to them. I was like, yeah, go for it. I mean, you get extra credit if you do that, sure. And they did it. And I was just wowed. Wow. They also had to memorize a statement of faith, and they did great with that. They have to read the entire Bible as another one of their requirements. If you can flip to that requirement slide, Pastor Brandon, sorry, he's multitasking. My man over here up on camera and over in the sound booth. Thank you. But there are certain, yes, memorize the Friends Club distinctives. On top of that, they have to pass the memory verse and, yes, read the entire Bible. So they did all of that. And I also have gotten to see them in youth group. I've gotten to go to youth camp with them last year. I'm gonna try not to cry, because these ladies have such an amazing future, and God has an amazing plan for their, He has an amazing plan for everybody. But when I tell you that these girls are gonna go so far in the kingdom and really share the gospel with other people, they've already done it. I mean, they bring people to youth group. Like, it is just, it's incredible. Stop. Okay. I really didn't think I was gonna cry. Okay, anyway, I'll be fine. But so proud of them. I know Pastor Hans has watched you guys, and he's not here tonight, but I know he would rave about both of you, and your parents have raved about you, and wow, it's just been an amazing time that I've been able to watch both of you. So again, back to the you know, requirements. They both have the purple cord, just showing that they have their graduation requirements all finished. That's what they walked in with. They also get a ring to symbolize their spiritual growth over the 3 years of middle school. And middle school is a beast. I don't know how long it's been since you've been in middle school. I'd say, I don't want to list the number of years it's been since I've been there, but it's nasty, especially if you go to public school. I mean, both are, but it's nasty sometimes. And so to have the word of God in their hearts and to show that to people around them in this world that we're in nowadays, it just speaks volumes to what the two of them can do. So with that being said, I'm going to have, do the moms have rings? If you can hand them their rings, you're okay. And each of them is going to get this ring. Again, it symbolizes the fact that of their spiritual growth over these 3 years. Mothers, you can go ahead and put those on your daughters. This is cute. Anyone want pictures? You can take them down. Yeah? Okay. I am going to, we can go ahead and clap for them, by the way. And the last step for them to do is just to say the friend's pledge before we finish with the honoring portion. So ladies, if you memorized it, fantastic. If you want to look off of that, you totally can, but I'm going to hand you the microphone to share.
You want to hold it?
Sure.
Okay. Whenever you want to start.
Okay. As a friend's graduate, I will be committed to our Jesus Christ,
our Lord, Christian values, family, friends, and church. I promise to encourage and provide accountability to those around me.
Okay, before I start crying again, I'm going to ask Jaylenise and her family to go ahead and step down. Thank you so much. And I'm keeping Gianna up here because not only is she graduating from Friends as an honoree, she also gets her silver medal tonight, which is a huge accomplishment because to get a silver medal in Girls Ministries, you not only have to honor in Friends, but you have to honor in Daisies, Prims, and Stars on top of it. So those are the requirements in order to get your silver medal. Gold medal is if you finish Girls Only, and bronze is if you finish as a Stars honoree. But fantastic job. So I get the privilege of doing that, which, you know, I don't want to cry again, but I'll try not to, okay? And up on the screen, you can see what those requirements are. Not only do you have to honor in all of those clubs, you also have to be a born-again Christian, as stated in the Bible. You also have to live a consistent Christian life, and again, I can personally say I've been a witness in that in her time that she's been here, and it has just been a privilege to get to say that up here. So, all right, you're gonna have to go down because I'm gonna start crying. But great job. I'm so proud of you, friend, good job. Oh, okay, I can't do this again next year, Pastor P. Someone else is gonna have to come up here because I'm going to have to take some kind of crying thing. Pastor Brandon, I feel what you feel now. If anyone knows, we're in our emotions sometimes. It's okay. All right. So last but not least, we have one more club to celebrate. That is our high school girls, our girls only group. If you would come on up to the stage. And they are led by Miss Carrie Plummer and Miss Sade Ojo. And we also have more ladies. Some of them are already off to college already, but and some don't like the limelight, so it's okay. It's fine.
Yes, we normally have about six more on most nights. We've had a lot of girls this year, which is awesome, and we've had a lot of new girls, which is lovely. And I'm always so thankful. Sorry, I'm always so thankful to welcome. No, it's okay. To welcome the. You know, the girls coming up from Friends, because I know that these girls are so welcoming. Any girl who comes in, you know, it's nerve-wracking to come to a new group. Everybody's older than you. They're all high school girls. And so they come up and they're all scared, right? Nylise and Mercy, you guys were scared. You guys came in all quiet and now they're very chatty. So, yeah, we love having these girls. And, you know, it starts out being the parents bringing them, which we love, so thankful for. But then as they get older, they're able to drive. And it's kind of up to them to come. Thankfully, they do often come, and it's just really awesome, and it's encouraging that they come and want to be in our group. Like I said, we are a very chatty group. So once we do, you know, rein in the conversation, they could literally talk for the entire hour and a half every single night. So once we rein it in, we do get some units completed. We only do 5 units each year, and we are working on our 5th one now. So this year we've done dating, we've done standing firm in our faith, family relationships, attitude, and we're currently working on knowing our talents and using them for the Lord. So now I will go through all of our girls here and the units that they've earned. I'll put this away. So first we have Olivia Harwood, and she has earned 1 unit this year. And then we have Nylise Tirado. She's earned 4 units. And then Mercy Rivera, who has earned 4 units as well. And we do have Hayden Thomas with us. She has only been here twice, I think. So she hasn't earned any units yet, but she is awesome. We love that she's here with us. And yeah, that's our group.
All right, ladies, you can go ahead and take a seat. Thank you, thank you. Yes, we had 3 graduates, Carrie. It's okay. I can. It's okay. It's all right. Olivia Avilas is one of our graduates. She's already at college. She just went this past weekend. I can't tell you how many units she had. It's on her certificate back there, but it's okay. She did a really good job. She was pretty, you know, she really, another one at youth group that really takes the initiative, invites people, really speaks about Jesus out in her schools and everything. So we're missing her already. We have Isabella Marsh, who's actually going to UD, moving in this weekend. She just joined us this past year, so she's another graduate. And am I missing another one? Savannah Fur, already at college too. Yes, and another one that's been within the program the past couple of years. So it's crazy that they're already out. But yes, we're gonna miss them. Okay, so you saw that every girl or boy got a little packet when they came up. That contains their certificate. It also contains a registration packet for this coming fall. It has a medical form for this coming fall. Please make sure that you're filling those out. We're also starting a new thing this year where every year to pay for the curriculum and their brand new t-shirt that we're getting. Can you flip to the t-shirt real quick, Pastor Brandon? Sorry. You have a helper in there with you now, huh? That's going to be, so it pretty much looks like that. The only thing is, when I converted it, the arch, the girls' ministries on the back of it is going to be in an arch. So every child's going to be getting this t-shirt unless they're in Noah Zoo Club. Noah Zoo Club's going to have their Noah Zoo Club shirt. But everybody else is going to be getting this t-shirt that pays their $25 registration fee. Again, that also covers your curriculum fee for the year. We pay for binders, we pay for booklets, we pay for lesson pages. Those aren't free. If you want to pay tonight, you totally can. Each table in the back is going to have leaders at it after we break in a second. If you don't want to pay tonight, that's okay. You can bring it on the first week back, which is going to be September 4th. I do want to do a plug real quick. Next week is the Royal Ranger Ceremony, so please make sure you come out and support them. They have and all of their accomplishments that they're doing, so that's next Wednesday. But that following Wednesday will be our first night back. So just like in school when you have to fill out all those packets and do your parent homework when you go to meet the teacher and all of those things in elementary, just like that. Again, I just want to thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you for bringing your kids. Thank you for giving them the opportunity to hear about Jesus. We can't do it without you. They can't do it without you. So thank you for making that a priority in their lives. I do want to pray us out real quick. And then, actually, before I pray, leaders, you can go ahead and head back to those tables right now if you'd like, just to get ready. And all right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, again, we just thank you for this opportunity tonight, God. I pray a blessing over every single child that's in this program, God. I pray a blessing over their families, Lord. I pray that you would just continue to work in their lives and help them to see the plan that you have for them, God. I thank you for every parent that showed up, every kid that showed up tonight, God. And we just pray for a wonderful rest of summer and a great beginning of the school year. In your name, amen. Thank you, everybody.